Zen is the art of nothing.
It is.
Oh, how beautiful. Nothingness. Basking in the nothingness. Something going on up here. It must be because, like, all these cars, they really want to get there, whatever's up there. So right here, it's a big, fat, wide shoulder. It's going to disappear into nothingness. But right now, I'm like, there's something up there. It must be good, whatever it is up there. Because it looks like, you know, the gold rush or something. You gotta go. Okay, 28 kilometers. That highway is scary, even though I've got a big wide shoulder, but that shoulder's gonna end up here anyway. So, there's nobody here. Okay, Friday night, July 21, 81 kilometers. Down here, certainly got my attention. I'm like, huh? I'm on the lake, right? Like, there's beacons. So I have stars that I can see. There's beacons. There's a green beacon here. There's a red beacon there. There's another red beacon over there. And these bright lights, those are ATVs. They have to be. And it's like the smallest base camp imaginable. 6.5 feet by 2 feet. It's exactly the size of a mattress. So, once I have this tiny little thing set up, I know I have a place to get out of insects. I have a mattress to lie on. I got pillows. I have a screen room. 90 kilometers or whatever. Set this up and walked for like an hour. I walked as far as I could go. And then, so basically I've walked. This is a big long beach. Now, the moon, there is no moon. There was a moon. There was a tiny little sliver of a moon, and it's gone, which makes this very dark. So I need waypoints. Dark. So over here, somebody put a big pile of driftwood. I think they're cleaning it up or something. And so this is a pile of driftwood. So you can't miss it if you're walking down the middle of the beach. So like if I got disoriented, which I just did, even though there's this huge pile of driftwood, I walked all the way to the end, turned around, walked right past it, and walked halfway down to that other peninsula and realized, whoop, I'm past this. So this pile of wood, which was not here last week, that marks the entrance to where I came in. Plus, I always do this in this spot. I put a few logs right down near the water, pointing into where I am, my bike is. It's quite fascinating the way this stuff sits still. And sometimes you can see almost like a stream of fog following the air coming. This behavior is fascinating. They all congregate and they're always grouped together. Morning. How are you? Having some snacks? The sun has made a little stripe in the lagoon. Pelicans were like right here. And I wasn't fast enough. These are a little less common than the rest of these birds, which are geese and gulls. It looks like these are the same group. They're here every week. So there's only like maybe 15 of them. And I was freaking out watching them on the other side of the lagoon last week because they huddle together like football player huddle. They're doing it right now over there. But like they were really tight in and beside each other, and yet they're all fishing. So they probably have some kind of tactic going on where they kind of scare fish in among themselves. They're feeding right now. Wow. Let's see if I can get closer. Okay, we're on the pelican hunt. The pelicans are now again. They're huddled together, right here, real close to shore. All these animals get spooked really easily, so I have to drop this blade. See what I can get out. And I wonder if it's clams or fish. There's minnows. I saw a guy catching minnows in the channel that feeds this lagoon. He's a very active ecosystem. Cool. Like, where else can you get this close to them? They're not very far away from me. They're just ignoring me. Maybe they don't see me. They're moving, so it's safe. I can get down here. Get down here. The geese are gonna be freaked out. The geese do not tolerate your presence really beside them. They're moving again. So they're moving like fast as I can walk. There. They seem to move pretty fast. So I'm gonna try it. I was riding the south wind to get here. Now it's completely 180. And you get white caps. For most of the year, when it's like this, it is freezing cold. Bikes up here on the dune, like usual. So I'm like about, it's gotta be 20 feet. Above the beach. You can see how big this is. Of all the space in there. What I used to do is put that mattress on the ground and have a chair. Healing out the beach chair. And I sewed a floor onto here. That really doesn't work. Because then I'm searching for rocks and everything. So this is better. This really works cool. Tent footprint material. Now, if I had get a zipper in one of these corners, the whole thing can stay pinned down. Not even that squirrel could get in here. Yeah, I mean, these Australian guys, if you ever look at what they do, everything is different. Like, everything is different. Swags. So a swag is like a big bedroll, which you could say that's kind of what I'm trying to do here. It's like unroll, clip, clip, boom. You don't need this. I didn't use this last night. People come from far and wide to shiver on this beach. You shall not pass. Area. Move away from the net. You do not have landing rights here. You will be ejected. Dude, you wanna watch me sleep behind Walmart? Actually, no, dude, no, I don't wanna watch that. So this is the channel. It feeds the lagoon over there. What? Oh, I wasn't paying attention. It's over. I didn't realize it's over already. Just ripples. Just tiny little ripples in this monster lake. Ah, it's freaky. Oh, there are a few people down there. This is almost empty. Zen is the art of nothing.
It is.
Oh, how beautiful. Nothingness. Basking in the nothingness. When you can find emptiness in a place that gets crazy busy, that's pretty interesting. Luna. I have a date with Luna tonight. She's very romantic. And that is like a 1/3 crescent, almost. There's the fog again. Fog blankets these fields. Six AM Monday morning, and that's the Winnipeg floodway. This is a little park, or this is the trailhead. Duff Roblin trailhead, and this is a rest stop. 1, 2, 3. Is it a heat wave? 11 degrees?